Hi there, my name is Dan. You and me are going to learn how to create our full screen background video website, both the video creation and building the website. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hey, and in this video we're going to look at creating a type animation in After Effects. A nice simple one, okay, just to get us going in After Effects. So we're going to grab the type tool, this guy up the top here. Okay, click that once. Now in the middle of our stage here, we're going to click once. Okay, and you'll see we get given a new line, which is great, empty text layer. And we're going to start typing. We're just going to type in our name. So actually let's type in, I'm going to type in BYOL. Okay, so I'm going to select it all. Okay, so I just drag a box over it, select it, and I'm going to pick a font. So the font's over here under character window. If you can't see, sorry, the character panel, go to window, and you should see them in there, character, to bring it up. Okay, and I'm going to make mine a little bit bigger so I can see it a bit better. Okay, and pick a font, any font. It doesn't matter what font you use. So I'm going to use Museo, one of my favorite new ones. I'm going to use the Museo slab. Okay, 700 size wise. Okay, in terms of the drop down menu here, you can pick this. This is kind of your standard fonts. They only go up to 72 for some magic reason. Okay, what you can do though is with it selected, watch this. You can just obviously type it in there. You can click in here and make it 120. Okay, but you'll find that everything in After Effects is what's called scrubbable. It means that it can be clicked and dragged across. So if I hover above any of these blue things, okay, I'm going to use font size, click, hold, and drag it to the right. And you can see it updates my font size on the right side, left and right. Okay, so get it up to a big-ish size. Mine's up to 210, I'm not too worried. To physically move it around now, go to this tool here. Okay, it's a little black arrow called the selection tool. I'm going to click this, and I'm going to move it down. Okay, and that's going to be, yeah, I've got a font, got a color. Now, if yours is coming out a different color, okay, highlight the text with the type tool, and here's your color thing here. Okay, you can pick some basic black and white, or you can click on this white or black box here, the bigger version, and you can use this to scroll up and down, okay, to get the hue. Once you've picked a hue, I'm gonna pick something in there, okay, and you can click in here to pick the color. Can you see it updating on the right? So you have to click in here. If you want it to be pure white, you click and drag it up to the corner or down here to the black. And I'm gonna pick something in this kind of murky blue. I'm gonna move it and make it a little more green. All right, click OK. The other thing you might notice is that it's pretty poor quality. You can see on my screen here, well, it depends on how you're viewing your video. You might have to stick it to HD. But in terms of mine's viewing it what's called quarter. Yours is probably defaulting to auto and probably got full. It just means that with it set to auto, it's gonna try and guess, is your machine old and crappy? It might go auto and might go down to quarter, okay, automatically. But if your machine's reasonably good and it's not being stressed out at the moment, it's probably gonna default to auto. So default to full. So leave it on auto and it will jump up and down as it needs to. If you wanna force it, okay, so you wanna see the quality of the image, you can force it to be full. I often force it to be full, okay, just because my machine's pretty good and I like to always look at it as good quality, but that's not always true. You might have to jump it down to quarter. And it just means like quarter quality. It doesn't change the output of it. Okay, the quality is still, when you finally render it, it's gonna be as good as you make it. It's gonna be full HD, this one. Okay, it just means while you're previewing it, it's gonna be a little bit lower quality. Right, so to do our animation, we're gonna make sure our timeline, okay, is all the way back here. This thing's called our CTI, our current time indicator. Nobody calls it that though, it's the playhead. Okay, so we're just gonna call it the playhead. So we're gonna drag along right to a 0, 0. You can tell them at 0, 0 over here on the left. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna zoom out a little bit. Okay, we're on fit before, so I'm gonna zoom out to maybe 50% just so I can see the edges. Now your screen, you might be working on a really big iMac, so you'd be able to see it at full, okay? Depending on your screen, I'm working on my little laptop here, so I've got it at 50%. You can also do is, for shortcuts, for zooming in and out, it's really quite common. If you hold down the control key and hit plus, it zooms in, and minus, it comes out. If you're on a Mac, hold down command plus and minus to zoom in and out. Right, so what I'd like to do is my animation is going to start off here on the right. So I'm just going to click and drag it with my selection tool. Okay, and what we're going to do is we're going to animate this layer here called BYOL. We're going to twirl down the edge. Okay, we're gonna twirl down transform, and this is where our basic kind of animation happens. You can see we can animate something called the anchor point, the position, where it is on the page, the scale of it, the rotation, and how see-through it is with opacity. So at the beginning here, okay, I wanna set my little keyframe for position. To do that, can you see this little guy down here? It's quite small, he's a stopwatch. Okay, literally like I'm gonna click the stopwatch and it's gonna start watching what I do. Okay, so it's gonna click it. Okay, now it's thinking and it's kind of watching what I'm doing. So what it's done is it's put a keyframe here, this little diamond, to say at frame zero, I am here at this X and Y position. Okay, and if I move it along a little bit, how far? It's up to you. I'm gonna go maybe a second and a half. Okay, and watch this. I'm gonna click, hold, and drag it across. If you just drag it, it kind of goes willy-nilly. If you hold shift while you're dragging, it kind of drags it across perfectly straight. It's up to you. You see that's put another keyframe in there at a different position. Okay, so my playhead here, there he is, he's off screen, but when I get across to this one, okay, he's on screen. So drag your playhead back, hit spacebar on your keyboard, preview it, okay, and it slides in. It's not very exciting, okay, it's just kind of sliding across, but yeah, well done. We've done our first bit of animation in After Effects. Two keyframes, a bit of boring type, and it slides in, and we are awesome. All right, one thing you might notice is mine's a little bit jumpy compared to yours. Yours might be even more jumpy. When I hit spacebar, what we're gonna do is keep an eye on this info panel here. If you don't have the info panel, is it the info panel or the preview? Yeah, the info panel. Okay, is go to window and find it. Okay, where is info? There he is. There, make sure he's on. Okay, and what you're gonna do is hit spacebar. I'm just gonna keep an eye over here. Watch this, hit spacebar. And it's previewing perfectly, okay? How I know it's not previewing perfectly, it's jumpy and it will go red over here and it will just kind of give you an indication of how fast it's trying to play. Watch this, if I adjust my keyframes a little bit, if I hit spacebar now, watch what this happens over here. If I hit spacebar, it's trying its best and it caught up with it fine. Okay, you might have your computer might be a little old or a bit full up, okay, it might be running pretty slowly. What ends up happening is it'll play once and try its best to get through, and then when it loops back around, it'll play nice. Can you see mine almost, oh, it's not quite keeping up, but then it plays a second time and it's all happy days. Oh, mostly happy days. Okay, it's kind of dropping off a little bit. And all I have to do maybe is drop it down to half, hit spacebar. Okay, and it will play, well, it's still not quite keeping up, even at that lower quality. The reason mine's doing so badly is that I've got screen capturing software running on mine so that you can follow along obviously with the videos, and it stresses my poor little machine out a little bit. So I'm gonna go back to full. Actually, I might go to auto. Then it can decide itself. See, it's decided half. All right, so that's our first bit of animation. It slides in. Okay, the next thing we're gonna do is get it to pause for a little while, which it's already doing. You can see it just pauses. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna get it to maybe drop down. Okay, so what we're gonna do is towards the end here, so maybe at about 8 seconds, I'd like it to start falling. So to do that, what we need to do is we want a keyframe here to keep it right here, because if I start dragging it down now, this happens quite a bit with people, watch this, I've got a keyframe here, where it's at the beginning, a keyframe here where he slides in, but then all the way between this guy, he's trying his very best, watch, to get down there, okay? What I want to do is between these two keyframes, it's just to wait for me, and then I want the animation to happen in this last little piece here, so I'm gonna undo. So instead of dragging it down here, what we're gonna do is we're gonna manually add a keyframe, and that's what this little diamond here does, watch, if I click it, hey, we've got a keyframe over here. It just says, remain where you are. So, keyframe on the right, in the center, another one in the center, so he just sits there, and then the last one at 9 seconds. For some reason, I got a bit of black video at the end here. That's my fault. It's not meant to be a black video. That's just my little mix-up when I made the little particle video. So what we're gonna do is click, hold, and drag it down. What was the key I hold down to make sure it goes in a straight line? Shift, you got it. Okay, so I'm gonna drag it just off screen. Now I'm gonna hit spacebar, it's gonna play, comes along, waits for a little while, and then little particles fall, and then down he goes. Okay, that's a little bit of animation. It's a little bit what I like to call PowerPointy. Okay, it's not very super slick and hasn't got any inertia and kind of movement. It's all very kind of like clunky at the moment, but we'll fix that up in another video. But that's it. Well done, buddies. We have made our first bit of type animation. Let's make sure we save it, okay, and move on to the next video.